Namaste. My name is Wisima. I'm International Meditation Master. I want to speak now, why is awareness so important? If we have a lack of awareness of our feelings and thoughts, then we can misunderstand the situation where we are right now, and this can even lead to separation, to wars, to an unhappy life as a result. For instance, there was this great psychologist, Alice Miller, and she went with her friend and their daughter to the kindergarten, and the child could not play. And Alice asked, what's going on? The mother explained, her father was leaving for work abroad, and she is missing her father. The child started instantly to cry, and after crying, this means after releasing of the feelings, she could play again. So this means that even children are not aware of our feelings, then for sure we are not aware of our feelings. So this means we try to feel our feelings maybe every 5 or 10 minutes or so. And when we want to make a great decision or important decision, for sure. So this means if we cannot feel our feelings, there are still our thoughts. And the feelings are creating the thoughts. If we have anger thoughts, then we have anger inside of ourselves. It's just so simple. Then you understand why I don't want that you manipulate your thoughts. Because through our thoughts, we can be aware what feelings we have suppressed. So why is it so important? Okay. For instance, a father is coming home full of anger, and then the child is not doing exactly what he wants. He's getting angry, blowing up his anger. And the reality is that the child has nothing to do with his anger and is a victim of him. So, and we can see it in meetings. Oh my God. And so the people are driven from their motives instead to find the best solution for everybody. But if they would be aware of their motives, of their feelings, then they could act good. For instance, when I'm very, my chief had made me very angry, no? And I meet him 1 hour later, and I'm not aware of my anger, but it's inside of myself, and for sure I will be not so friendly, I'm not open for the moment. And if I would be aware of my anger, then I would simply say, so you have made me very angry because of this and this and this, and the situation is saved. I'm out of the situation. And this we can do everywhere. And if we don't do so, our negative suppressed feelings are driving our decision, what I said before in the meetings. The people are looking not what's inside of themselves and decide after their suppressed feelings, for sure they decide wrong. This is all just a lack of awareness. And now comes a good thing. If I'm aware of my anger, and if I would feel my anger, anger is done. And my attitude is getting better. If I do it always, my attitude is getting better and better and better. This is even science proved. When we watch something, the situation is changing. Through our watching alone. And this is the reason why meditation is working. You watch your feelings and thoughts as a witness. This means you are not identified. What's that Zen so nice? Feel your feelings and don't be identified with them. The identification is the problem. Not the bad feelings. Then just release them. Okay, I'm angry, that. Okay, I feel that. Okay, fine. What's the problem? If I'm not aware of it, this will cause negative suppressed feelings and they cause wrong decisions in my life. Most of all accidents happen because of suppressed negative feelings. We're in a rush, we have to act, we have to drive faster and faster and all these things, and then we could not see it because we had these tomatoes in front of our eyes. This was our problem, and we washed the accident. Unnecessary. Okay. So I have experience with that. Okay. Thank you that I could speak with that. And bye.